What's up, guys? Frank here in Salem, Massachusetts,
home of infamous witch stories and all around Halloween town. But I'm not here to chase down ghosts. Today I'll be talking to Kurt Ballou, guitarist and songwriter of Converge, as well as the illustrious producer at God City Studios, where he single-handedly made some of the best records in the past couple years. I'm here with Kurt Ballou at God City Studios. Say what's up to the world.
What's up, world?
What's the origin story of the studio?
I started recording on four tracks, you know, shortly after I started playing guitar. I never owned a four track, but I'd like borrow my friend's four tracks and, you know, just to get my ideas out and then, you know, record my friend's band's demos. This is like long before there was GarageBand or any kind of, you know, easily accessible computer software. So, you know, we did it on tapes. And by the time I could like afford money to get a four track, I had enough money to buy an eight track. So I bought a half inch eight track, started, you know, just demoing my own songs so I could hear them back. And then eventually that became 7 inches. And then, you know, the gear improved. And then I started doing albums. I got laid off from my day job. I was a biomedical engineer. I got laid off from that in 2001. They gave me like a really nice severance package, and like Converge, my band, was starting to do pretty well at that point. So kind of had the choice of like see how long I could do music and try to keep that going for a little while, or try to find another job in my chosen profession. And I decided to do music for a while because the studio was busy at that point. I started searching for a building and I found this place.
And I can vouch, it's pretty awesome. It's beautiful here. So
thank you. Should be I worked proud. Hard on it.
In your personal opinion, like what would be the more favorable albums that you've worked on because of experience or the end product? Or
I'm always terrible about naming favorite anything. You know, like the Converge records are probably the most important to me because it's the songs that I've written. Or the most rewarding records are usually the ones that have like a certain element of struggle. And you're able to like overcome that adversity of making a record and still make something that you consider to be great. And so like the Young Widows album I did is sort of like that. We made like a big matrix of what we were going to use from each performance and then put it together in a really bizarre way. It was, and also I had like nowhere near enough time to do the project in, but it still turned out great. So like things like that are really rewarding to me. You know, when I'm able to take like the non-conventional path to making a record and it still turns out good. I'm into that. And then this also, you know, like breakthrough records for me, like certain milestones. Converge's No Heroes was the first Converge record that I recorded and mixed without anybody else's assistance. So that was like real important to me that I was, you know, I felt like, okay, now I've come of age and I can do this better than anybody else can do this. Cave In Until Your Heart Stops was pretty important because that was like the first album that I think I ever did. Or at least the first one that ever got any kind of recognition. There's another band that I just recorded again recently called Pygmy Lush. A few of the guys in that band were in Page 99, so like aggressive music fans might be more familiar with them through that. But their music sort of falls more in line with Nazi Star, Tom Waits, Nick Cave, like Americana but dark, and that's more along the lines of my current taste in music. So getting to record a band that's actually like a great band in the genre that I'm excited about is really, you know, it's just really fun for me.
Plus I'm sure it's pretty awesome to like step away from doing constant metal records all the time.
Yeah, it gets a little boring after a while, you know. Like I mean I'm good at doing it, but it's the thrill's gone a little bit, you know. And I hate to say that because I know that a lot of people would love to like step into my position and get to work on metallic hardcore records every day, but I've been doing metallic hardcore records every day for like 10 or 15 years, plus going on tour with my band and seeing like four or five metallic hardcore bands every day on tour.
Pretty much all your recordings kind of have like this Kurt Ballou stamp or sound to them, but at the same time they don't actually sound all alike. Like you can't clump them all together and be like, all right, they all sound exactly the same. What's your method, I guess, for keeping things diverse?
I guess two things. Well, first of all, I try to think of each band as their own thing, even if they have some overlap with other groups. You know, I try to understand their frame of reference, first of all, in terms of where they're coming from musically. And when I'm recording Black Breath, I definitely get myself into a Swedish death metal mindset, you know. And like when I'm recording you guys, I don't. You know, I wouldn't want to like try to impose a Swedish death metal sound on a band that's not like going for that. One thing that helps ensure that happens is that I never do the same thing twice. You know, it's not like I have my this is my mic that I use on bass drum, and this is my compressor that I use on the vocal, and this is my whatever. You know, like, that stuff is different all the time. But it's still all filtering through my ears and my ideals of good sound. So there is that, like, you know, there's that common element of that that's in all my mixes.
And, I mean, do you have, like, a favorite piece of equipment or memento in the studio?
The Bug Zapper mic, but that's not set up right now. But there's this AEA-R88. It's a stereo ribbon mic. It's about, like, it's way better than this mic. It doesn't say metal injection on it. But it's, you know, it's, like, probably about twice as long as this mic is, and it's cool looking. It looks like a Bug Zapper, and it sounds great on everything. It's like the mic that I have that's the closest to being a mirror of what something actually sounds like in the room.
Over the years, you've been contacted by a lot of bands, and you're somewhat selective of the bands that you work with. What do you look for in a band that you do want to work with?
I look for a band that puts artistic goals ahead of business goals. The kind of music that I like is not usually accessible enough that it requires management. So if someone has management, it's usually like telltale sign to me that it's probably not something I'm going to be into. There's obviously exceptions to that, you know, like a Slayer's management called me up tomorrow and said, hey, we want you to do the new Slayer record. Of course we're going to do the new Slayer record. But like when there's like a bunch of like 19-year-old kids from Sacramento, when their manager contacts me, it seems weird to me. I'll always like ask a band, you know, what they're hoping to achieve when making a record.
World,
you know,
peace.
Yeah, well, that would be great. But I also try to like seek out a band's lyrics if I'm not familiar with them and make sure that they don't have like a political or social agenda that I don't agree with. You know, I'm not, you know, if a band's like really misogynistic or Christian or, you know, hateful in some kind of way, like I'm trying to avoid having my name attached to that kind of stuff.
If we could talk about CONVERGE for a second.
Sure.
What's going on with the, you know, in the CONVERGE camp? Because I know that there's been a lot of rumors lately about a new record coming out in 2011, but I understand that might not be entirely accurate.
I think we're going to do, we may do a split 7-inch at some point in 2011, but the chance of an album are incredibly low. But we've got some songs that we're working on. There's like, I think 6 or 7, let's see, what is it? It's like January now. So in January of 2011, we've got 6 or 7 songs that we're working on. We're going to get together and practice next week or the week after, I think. Maybe write some more, maybe just try to finish up those songs that we're working on. We're not really worried about an album cycle or anything like that. You know, we don't have like a tour that we have to do that we need to get a record out in time for or anything like that. So when the inspiration's there, we're going to write songs. And, you know, once we have enough songs to make an album, we'll record an album. And we won't be doing that until we have, you know, sufficient inspiration in order to make a record.
And as far as, you know, like the album writing goes or just writing in general, Axe to Fall was kind of regarded as, you know, CONVERGE's best record by many publications, blogs, and even yourself. Do you feel like any pressure that you have to kind of like top it or something like that?
I don't really feel a lot of pressure from critics or the public or anything like that. But I mean, we feel pressure on ourselves, not necessarily to top it, but I'm happy with lateral moves at this point in my life. As long as I'm able to continue to make records that I'm proud of and enjoy, I'm happy. We've put out a lot of records now. We've put out a lot of records in the same sort of style. Like I don't mind. I don't want to say that I wouldn't mind having an off record, but like if you look at like the Melvins, they have like milestone records and they have like in between records that they do just for fun. You know, you can tell like they were more about the process than they were about the result. So they were just trying to enjoy their creative process and put out a new record, because they put out a bazillion records, you know, right. So they don't need to, like, not everyone has to be the next Houdini. That's not to say that our next record is going to be a cop-out, but I kind of feel like our next record is just going to be, like, a metal record. CONVERGE is known for being an innovative band, but it might just be more like the 14-year-old thrash metal fan in me coming out. And that's still, like, the musical ground that the four of us share is like, that thrash stuff, so... You know, we might end up doing like a thrash record. Who knows? You know, I'm just at the beginning of writing, so who knows what'll actually happen. But, you know, maybe then the next record after that will be some like real slow, dark, you know, like Swans meets Death in June kind of record or something like that. Like, I like the idea of having, you know, each record have its own personality. And I feel like when we were younger, there was like a little bit of pressure to make each record like a greatest hits record. I don't really feel that pressure anymore. I just want to make records that I'm proud of, that I enjoy, that I would want to listen to if I wasn't in the band.
Always awesome talking to you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, no problem.
And check out CONVERGE.
Yes, check us out. We're really, really good.
you've been very selective with the bands that you work with.
Probably because your cock is so big, it's just pushing it off the seat.
Where was I?
I don't know. Why don't you look at your dick?